My favorite kind of salad, Caesar salad. Would you like some Caesar salad with that? Welcome to Fun with History. And today we are going to go into the lesson of Would You Like Some Caesar Salad with That? I hope you're intrigued. Please come back after our introduction once again. Welcome to Fun with History with your professor, Professor Banks. And Professor Banks has a bit more of a better voice than he did last week, although still a lot of coughing at nighttime, so I may be getting this checked out shortly because I think there's something going on with my coughing. But anyway, Professor Banks is here today to do his lesson for you folks. So, without further ado, let's get into the joke of the week, shall we? And then we'll get into our lesson. Okay, this is called a genie funny. I think a lot of us would like to have our own little genie, so this is a little funny joke about it. A secretary, a paralegal, and a partner in a big law firm are walking through a park on their way to lunch when they find an antique oil lamp. They rub it and a genie comes out in a poof of smoke. The genie says, "I usually only grant 3 wishes." That's 3 wishes. So I'll give each of you just one. Me first, says the secretary. "I want to be in the Bahamas driving a speedboat without a care in the world." Poof, she's gone. Then the paralegal speaks up and he says, Me next. "I want to be in Hawaii, relaxing on the beach with my personal masseuse, an endless supply of exotic foods, and the love of my life." And then poof, he's gone. So the partner is the only one left. And the genie says to the partner, "You're next." Genie says to the partner, "What would you like?" Partner says back to the genie, "I want those two back in the office right after lunch." So, I hope you get a chuckle out of that funny joke there. But anyway, that is our joke of the week. All right. So, we are still looking at Rome. That is where we are spending our time still this week. And today, I want to talk a little bit to you about a very powerful man in the Roman world that really was a big force in extending the Roman Empire as big as it got. And I don't know if any of you have guessed who I'm going to talk about with my little catchy title, but I'm going to talk about Julius Caesar. That is our lesson today. And then I'm going to actually go briefly over a couple of other little things in this lesson to prepare ourselves for the lesson next week, which is going to be a bit of an extensive lesson next week on Rome. Okay, so Julius Caesar. Julius Caesar, this is his time frame here. Okay, so he was in the time frame of 100 to 44 BC. That's Julius Caesar's time. And I got on my board some stick figures. How many of you out there like stick figures? I thought I'd make it a little creative today too. No special guest with us today, but stick figures on the board. So Julius Caesar, let me tell you a little bit about him first, what he was. He was a Roman general and a statesman, okay, in Rome. And he fought in several wars. So he was very good at fighting in wars, and he was a very strong leader in that regard. So what he did, he wanted to get a big bite out of Rome. So he wanted to extend that empire as far as he could, and he liked the idea of power. So what Julius Caesar did was he set himself up quite well to accomplish that goal. So he formed an alliance. Okay, so he knew, he understood the concept that the game show Survivor, even in 100 BC, all these years ago. But he formed an alliance with a couple of other men. Okay, and here's my little stick figures. So the man on your left-hand side there is Crassus. And Crassus was a Roman general, as just like Caesar was, and he was also a politician. And he was the wealthiest man in Roman history. So that is why Caesar aligned himself up with him. He thought, this is a good guy to have in my back pocket. So he got Crassus, being the wealthiest man in Roman history, to be on his side. So he wouldn't ever have to worry about finances or anything like that with having him on his side. And then on the right-hand side here, he had a man named Pompey. And Pompey was a military and political leader, and he had a very wealthy background, just like Crassus did. So he has set himself up with politicians and military people and wealthy people. That is a good combination of people to line yourself up with. So he aligned himself up with those two Roman gentlemen. And under Julius Caesar, Rome did have a lot of war. Okay, so 60 years of civil war underneath the reign of Julius Caesar. And Julius Caesar fought many wars, as I alluded to before. Now, what he actually did, he actually formed the Roman Empire. Okay? That is what one of his dubious distinctions is. He formed the Roman Empire. Because when he came on the scene, it was basically a Roman Republic. And the Roman Republic at that time was overrun with crime. People were afraid to go out into the streets. There was no work, high taxes. It was not very good. But he came on the scene, Julius Caesar, and he thought, you know what? These people probably are getting tired of having crime overrun their city and people are afraid to go out into the streets. So he came on the scene, and because of what he wanted to do and the changes he wanted to make, he kind of got good approval in the people's eyes, in the Roman citizens' eyes. They kind of liked this guy. They thought, oh, you know what? I think he's going to make things better. And then we get the transition from the Roman Republic into the Roman Empire, the big empire. Okay, so let me tell you a little bit more about what he did. This is going to be kind of brief and to the point. And I got some of this on here. King of Pontus. Okay, King of Pontus. That was one thing about Julius Caesar, was in 74 BC, he combated the King of Pontus. Now, I don't have a map this week. I will have a map shortly about something else, but not on this topic. So I can't show you where Pontus is, but he combated the King of Pontus, who had actually declared war on Rome. So he, again, saw favor in the people's eyes, like, because this guy had declared war on Rome, and he defeated him, and the people were like, This Julius Caesar guy's a pretty cool guy. We like him. You know, he's good in our eyes. And then another thing that was pretty, another thing that he conquered in the Roman Empire was he conquered Gaul. Okay, so Gaul was back then, that was France. That was what Gaul was known as. So in 58, it took him 8 years overall, but he did conquer it. 58 to 50 BC, he secured the governorship of Gaul, which is now France and Belgium. That's modern-day France and Belgium, which allowed him a bigger military. And he conquered the rest of Gaul and even up to the River Rhine he conquered. So he conquered that area, and that became part of the Roman Empire. And another thing that he did as well was he actually attacked Great Britain. And so Great Britain also became under the influence of the Roman Empire at this time because of Julius Caesar's advancements in attacking Great Britain. And the city of London, which is actually another city I have been in, that was one of the cities I went to on my honeymoon that I talked about last week. City of London was actually born under the Roman Empire. So it was the Roman Empire that kind of created that city. And it's quite a royal, lovely, majestic city. And that is because of the Roman Empire and Julius Caesar, with the way he attacked Great Britain and got Great Britain underneath Romans' control. Okay, so let me see what else we talk about him on. Let's talk about the Civil War, shall we? Let's talk about what that was about. So, the Civil War, 60 years of Civil War, what happened, let me tell you a little bit about that. So, with the way Julius Caesar was advancing, you know, he conquered Gaul. He was in an alliance with these two strong, mighty men. That was like an alliance that seemed to be, that seemed to not be able to be broken. And he kind of conquered some of these areas. The Senate, okay, so the Senate was representing the people for the people. The Senate got a little bit afraid of Julius Caesar. They did not like Julius Caesar. The people, they liked Julius Caesar, but the Senate did not. And they were very afraid of Julius Caesar and the power that he was gaining and the power that he might be able to continue to gain. So they weren't very happy with Caesar, and they kind of started a little bit of a battle with him. So that was one element of the Civil War, was Julius Caesar fighting the Senate. And Julius Caesar started to get kind of a little upset, and he started to get mad with fighting the Senate. And so he actually decided upon himself. And again, Survivor hadn't even been created at this time, the show Survivor. But Julius Caesar thought it might have been, because he did something that you see a lot in the show Survivor. He decided to break his alliance. He decided to turn against somebody in his alliance. And that somebody was Pompey. So the Civil War kind of went from the Senate, with the Senate and Julius Caesar. And then he went on and he actually turned on Pompey and kind of started a bit of a war with Pompey. Pompey ran. He was afraid. He didn't want to deal with Julius Caesar. So he ran, and he actually ran to Egypt. And Julius Caesar was out to kill Pompey, but Pompey fled to Egypt, and so did Caesar. But Caesar could not. Pompey ended up dying, but not because of Caesar. He ended up dying in an Egyptian court over there, and Caesar did not ever catch up with him. So, but Julius Caesar became so strong, he became really Rome's first true dictator. and his power was starting to become very fearful to the Senate, for sure. So, and another thing he did when he was in Egypt, I might want to add this too, is, excuse me, he took up with Cleopatra, and Cleopatra was very high up in the Egyptian society at that point, and he took up with her, even though she was actually already married to Mark Antony. And Mark Antony was actually another prominent Roman figure. So Julius Caesar and Cleopatra had an affair. So Julius Caesar kind of was a little bit shrewd, and he was starting to do things that weren't very nice. And he did ascend the Roman Empire, no doubt, and he was very powerful, but he was doing things that weren't very good. So finally that caught up with Julius Caesar, and the Senate was getting tired of him, and 60 of the Senate members plotted to kill Julius Caesar right in the Senate. So they set up the trap for Caesar. He was in the Senate, and when he came into the Senate with the trap, they were there waiting for him, and Julius Caesar in 44 BC was stabbed to death. So, his power became too big, and he ended up paying the price for being stabbed to death. But some of the good things he did, obviously, was he aided in the Roman Empire becoming even bigger with some of the territory he conquered. So that is a bit of a nutshell story on Julius Caesar, trying to make it basic and to the point. So, that is what I had on my whiteboard there. Now, one thing I want to talk about as well in this lesson, because next lesson, I got a lot to kind of pack into it with a big lesson on the Roman Empire. But what happened with the Roman Empire, it obviously became very big, and it became actually too big. And what happened with the Roman Empire when it became too big? It covered most of Europe, it covered North Africa, parts of Asia. North Africa is what I talked about last week with Carthage. And just getting messages from Rome to the other parts of the empire took weeks. And we didn't live in the age where we had the internet and email and instant communication back then. So the empire had become too large to rule effectively. And the outer provinces are pretty much doing whatever they wanted. So the emperor at the time, Diocletian, was looking for a way to fix this and other problems. And he decided that the only thing to do was to actually break the empire into two pieces. One piece would be the Western Empire based in Rome. The other was the Eastern Empire based in Byzantium. Okay, and I do got a map of this, people, so hold on here. Let me find my map. Sorry. I am looking for my map. There it is. So, this is the map. So there is, it's not a very bright map, but basically it was divided right down the middle, and the western part of the empire operated out of Rome, and the eastern part operated out of Byzantium, it was named. Byzantium later became Constantinople, and Constantinople later became Turkey, obviously. So that is a little bit of an understanding of that. So it was divided into half, And what happened over time was the East and West did not work together very well when it was divided into half, and that did create some problems, which we are going to look at next week. But so that's what happened with the Roman Empire. It was divided into two. And I am going to give you, I am going to say something else here in my little lesson here. So, Diocletian split the empire into two pieces, which I talked about. I'm going to give you a little bit of a history of the emperors a bit too. There was an emperor named Nero, and in 54 AD he became the emperor. So AD, not BC, AD, he became the emperor, and he was a very bad emperor, and he actually kind of had a lot of evil ways to him. And he caused trouble. And one of the things he did was he actually set fire to Rome. And it heavily damaged Rome. It heavily damaged the Colosseum and the Forum. And that's why the Colosseum kind of became no more after the Emperor Nero. Diocletian, we talked about him already. And another big thing that you have to, another big thing about the emperors that's very important to understand, it's a very important development, was the Emperor Constantine. And that is where Constantinople was named after. It was named after him in the eastern part of the Roman Empire. And what was the biggest thing about him was, and I'm just going to stop. Basically, Constantine, when he came onto the scene, there wasn't very good order in the Roman Empire, and he restored that order, and he became the first emperor to convert to Christianity, and he established Constantinople as the new capital of the Eastern Empire. And during the decades of him, the empire was divided along an east-west axis with dual power centers in Constantinople and Rome. So, and that was important. It was important. It was a very important event, him converting to Christianity, because a later emperor, Theodosius, the last emperor to rule over both east and west, died in 395 AD after making Christianity the official religion of the empire. So, that is a little bit about the division of the Roman Empire and emperors that you need to know about a little bit. Nero, Constantine, and Diocletian. Okay, those are probably the three biggest emperors that are talked about in Roman history. Nero was bad, Diocletian, Constantine mostly good. So that is basically what I wanted to talk to you about today, was Julius Caesar and his life and what he did for the Roman Empire. And I also wanted to touch base on the division of the Roman Empire and those three emperors, because the division of the Roman Empire actually weakens the Roman Empire to a certain extent, and the East and West do not have a good, are not well working together. And that sets up things nicely for next week, because next week we are going to see the end of the Roman Empire, and we are going to look at many reasons why that happened. But the division of the Roman Empire was a pretty big thing in the Roman Empire. And actually, one of them you're going to see goes on for years and years, while the other half does not make it. So, division is never usually a good thing. It usually does impede things after a while. So that is the lesson for today. I want to end there. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned a little bit more about Julius Caesar today. And Julius Caesar actually made a contribution to the Roman society that actually transferred right down to our society. And I'll look at that next week too. I'm going to kind of combine that with next week. But I hope you enjoyed your Caesar salad today. I hope you like it. It's my favorite salad, but that being said, it's the only salad I eat. But would you like some Caesar salad with that? Make sure that you say yes. And then say, that was after Julius Caesar. But I hope you enjoyed the history lesson this week. Next week, we are going to, I'll just basically tell you, next week we're going to look at the fall of the Roman Empire. And that is going to set us up for next week. So until next week, take care. And this is Professor Banks signing out. And please, continue to watch the videos, and I hope that you continue to find them funny. And please leave comments below. Anything you'd like to see in the videos, let me know. And until next week, take care.